Our next report tells you about another broken promise by China. In the early months of the pandemic, China banned the use of pangolin scales in medicine. Illegal wildlife trade was identified as a pandemic trigger by scientists. Has China stopped it? A new report says pangolin scales are still being used in traditional Chinese medicine. Take a look at how China is circumventing its own ban.
An endangered animal is being hunted to extinction in China. The pangolin, said to be the world's most trafficked mammal. China's obsession with pangolins is centuries old. Its meat is prized as a delicacy, and the scales are used in traditional medicine. There's nothing legal about any of this. China's pangolin trade is in defiance of a global ban. But to many Chinese, that's what makes it exciting. 200,000 pangolins are consumed in Asia every year. Chinese traditional medicine is the biggest consumer. Pangolin scales are like a panacea for the Chinese. It is believed to improve blood circulation, cure impotence, and increase lactation. Tall claims, but medically unproven. Earlier this year, China appeared to have a change of heart. Pangolin scales were banned from use in traditional medicine. It was partially due to mounting evidence that pangolins were carriers of coronavirus strains. The world community was upbeat. Conservationists were drawing up plans to revive the pangolin population. But this is China. Things are never as straightforward as they seem. A UK-based environmental group has busted China's deception. Pangolin scales are still being used in traditional medicine, and China is making no efforts to hide it. 221 companies have been licensed to use pangolin scales. You can find their products on e-commerce sites like eBay. So was China lying about the ban? Technically, no. Pangolin scales were removed from a list of so-called key ingredients, but they can still be used to make patent medicines. These are drugs approved for commercial production by the Chinese government. 8 such drugs are still in circulation. But what about sourcing? Where do these companies get pangolins from? It's a question best posed to the Chinese government. Beijing permits companies to use pangolin scales from its national stockpile. Very little is known about this buffer. It is described as shrouded in mystery and never-ending. What's more, China's medical insurance system continues to cover remedies involving pangolin scales. In short, China was never serious about curbing pangolin trade. It was an effort to appease the international community. This is not just limited to pangolins. China continues to be the hub of illegal wildlife trade, an industry worth around $20 billion. But China is playing a dangerous game. Wet markets and slaughterhouses are breeding grounds for viruses. They have already unleashed 2 major outbreaks in the world, claiming tens of thousands of lives. Which brings us to the question, why is China reluctant to curb wildlife trade? The answer is, it's a game of appeasement. Exotic meat is consumed mostly by China's elite, a group that the communist leadership is unwilling to antagonize. Bureau report, WEON, World is One.
Thank you for watching Gravitas on WEON's YouTube channel. If you want to stay up to date with what's happening around the world, then subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like and share. Thank you very much for watching WEON, World is One.